over the last 7 weeks that I've been running, I have become even more passionate about this cause because I have seen so many examples of places around the world, and I've run through so many dry riverbeds and dry lakes and places that had water before and don't have water now, that I'm even more passionate about the cause than I was when I started.
What makes you think you'll be able to make a difference after all of this?
For me, it's all about saying, how can we make a difference? How can we really make the world a better place, and how can we join people together? And what I've seen is that just me running has joined together literally thousands of people around the world who've been following me. People have been making declarations to reduce their water consumption, everything from choosing to drink tea rather than drink coffee, or to become vegetarian to just one meal, or to give up chocolate. I had a whole bunch of my girlfriends that gave up chocolate for 7 weeks that I was running. And all of these small things seem like kind of crazy stuff, but actually they make a huge amount of difference to our water consumption on the planet.
How did your body and mind cope with the vast changes or differences in temperatures? Bearing in mind you've gone from Jordan one day and then you find yourself in Antarctica the next.
Yeah, so it was actually pretty interesting because I had always thought that this would be a big issue. And, you know, it's really hard to think about how you adapt and how you plan for something like this. I was doing, what I just did is something nobody in the world has ever done before. So I went from Jordan, which is really hot, to Antarctica minus 20, back to Australia, which was even hotter. And when I got off the plane in the middle of Australia, literally the middle of Australia, I felt like I had stepped into an oven and turned the fan on. It was 47 degrees Celsius. That's a 67 degree Celsius difference. That's like 150 degrees Fahrenheit temperature difference. So it was enormously challenging and difficult to manage hydration, to manage my salts and electrolyte balances. And it was something that was much more mentally and emotionally challenging than I had expected. I knew it would be physically difficult. What I didn't really understand properly was just how emotionally challenging and draining the whole thing would be. Each desert was incredible and in its own way, but Antarctica was just something special. There are days in Antarctica where you can't tell the difference between the sky and the ground. It all just merges into a big white, you feel like you're in the middle of an eiderdown blanket. It's incredible. And the light there is quite unusual in that when it's the sun is in a kind of strange moment, you can't actually tell the difference in texture on the ground. So it's the first time I've ever felt like what it must be like to run without being able to see properly, because you can't gauge where you're putting your feet. And all of these made running in Antarctica really challenging. And what particularly made it even harder was the fact that I had no support crew with me at the time. So I'd flown down there, said goodbye to my team, and landed in this really strange place for me. I didn't grow up in the snow from Australia, and getting off the plane and just kind of being in the shock of, wow, it's super cold, it's completely strange and unusual conditions for me, was emotionally really hard.
What was the most positive message of support that you received, and who was that from?
Okay, it's so hard to even begin to tell you, because there were moments when we got tweets from like celebrities. The Queen of Jordan tweeted for me when I was in Jordan. That was just amazing. We had some other celebrity tweets from different people around the world. And that was great because it was just a confirmation that this is a message that's reaching people everywhere. And celebrities have the capacity to amplify messages. So getting them to tweet was great. But some of the most emotionally rewarding moments were when people I didn't know came up to me and offered their support.
What is next for you, and how will you measure the success of this?
We've already been enormously successful on this campaign. Over a billion people have seen our messages. Hundreds of thousands of people have made declarations to reduce their water consumption. And so for me, when we set out to do this, it wasn't about raising money. It was about raising awareness, and we've done that incredibly well, better than I could possibly have imagined.